All right, so intro. So we cheers and then topic DCEU and
DC Cinematic Universe.
well, they're calling it the DCEU.
DC Extended Universe?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Marvel Cinematic Universe, I'm thinking
Yeah.
of.
We'll just say DC movies.
Okay. DC movies, yeah. Okay, ready?
It's recording.
Oh, we're doing this. Okay. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the third episode of Jesse and the Hurricane.
Woo!
Let's do this. Ooh, that one hit the spot.
Today, we're talking about DC movies. Johnny?
Right off the bat, trailers.
Trailers? They're not that good.
They are good. That's the good thing about them.
Yes. In essence, they are very good trailers.
The trailers are the good part. Whoever's putting these trailers together is a genius.
They need to put together the movie.
Yeah.
If they put together the movie, how the trailers are put together, that'd be one hell of a movie.
It'd be a great movie.
Suicide Squad would have won an Emmy, for sure.
Or an Oscar.
You know, both. It would have been made into a show.
They won for makeup.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
Yeah. The makeup was good, though.
I mean, but
that was a good Harley Quinn.
Yeah,
but that's okay. Besides the point. Right. What we're trying to say is the trailers give you this kind of, what's the word I'm looking for? It makes me want to watch the movie, which that's what its job's supposed to do.
It hypes you up.
But then when you watch that movie, it's not what was in the trailer.
No, it's scenes in the trailer. There's scenes in there that aren't even in the movie that mislead you, and that's why I kind of just I'm over trailers at this point, because you see all these scenes.
You don't even watch trailers anymore.
I really don't.
Yeah,
honestly, I've kind of
I love them.
You know, I like the It trailer that came out recently. I was excited to see that because, you know, that's just something I've been wanting to watch.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Like these trailers of Batman or Superman, and even the new ones, like, you know, Wonder Woman. I'm wondering what's gonna be in the movie.
And just to clarify, we're talking about. This, we're not talking about the Nolan films.
No.
We're not, this is just these, this movie thing alone.
I don't even remember watching the Nolan Batman trailers.
I don't remember. I don't think I was into trailers when those movies
came out. Yeah, right.
I think that's why they were so good, though, because everything was brand new. Maybe The Dark Knight. The Dark Knight trailer.
Yeah, probably.
But anyway, so.
Yeah, the trailers are very misleading.
Yeah, very misleading. And the movies end up just being horrible. I mean, let's be honest. I think this movie, Man of Steel, was kind of better than Batman Superman. Batman Superman is just a big bag of stuff all into one.
True.
And I wasn't impressed.
General Zod, I like General Zod in that movie.
It was rare.
He was... But that Man of Steel movie was, I did, it was good. It was a little dark for my taste.
Very grounded.
Very grounded.
Everybody's all about being grounded with their movie.
Which is cool, but I think that's really hard to do with an alien from another planet that's able to fly and do all these superhuman things. You can't really get too grounded with that.
Yeah.
And that's why I think they went a little too dark with it. Like, literally, the shade of the movie is, this is dark.
This is the poster, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what I just want to say, when do you see Superman in the comics?
From here up is just dark.
Yeah, this is all black.
Yeah.
Where's the bright blue, the bright red, something that's the opposite to Batman?
Because he's a symbol of hope, and there's not much hope in darkness.
The darkness is in Batman.
That should be a t-shirt. There's not much hope in darkness. Just saying that. Hasn't been done yet. Just made it up right now on the spot.
But boss, anyway. Trademark.
So yes, this means darkness, and that's what they're going for completely. They might show jokes in the trailers, just like going back to the trailers, they show a lot of joking, but it doesn't have that same kind of...
Doesn't have the same feel, yeah.
Like, yeah, if you start with a movie that's dark, it's not going to do that. I mean, Suicide Squad was somewhat funny.
They tried to make it comedic with you know, Harley Quinn and her interactions with everybody, but it the movie was just, it was weird. It was weirdly put together.
Three things that I liked about that movie.
What's up?
Harley Quinn, Deadshot, and the 21 Pilots song. That's it. I didn't like it. I was over it. The villain sucked.
Yeah.
The movie was everywhere. Like, it felt like I was watching a music video a little bit. It's overall horrible. I think that's what it is.
I really like seeing Batman on top of a bright pink Lamborghini. That was pretty cool.
I didn't like the Joker.
Yeah, like, no, okay, that's a whole other topic.
Yeah.
Let's yeah. stop you.
And then Batman, Superman, Batman was the only thing good about that. Lex Luthor sucked.
He was great. I think Jesse Eisenberg killed that movie in the worst way.
Yeah.
If we can get
a Bryan Cranston type of Lex Luthor up
here. If you had Heisenberg playing Lex Luthor.
Mm-hmm. He already has a haircut.
Man, if he was shooting it while he was shooting Breaking Bad, that would have been a vicious.
Still had that like anger in his like his acting.
Yeah. Yeah. Similar roles. For sure.
Yeah.
That would have been awesome. Cause he would
that would have made the movie on another level, another scale.
Cause you're only as good as your villain.
Yeah.
In the movie.
And he's gotta be like just as big. I think in the comics he's just as big as
yeah.
Superman.
And he's older usually, right?
Yeah.
I think he's like, you know,
they're about the same age, I think.
Are they
about
really?
The same age. Okay. Yeah, they kinda did that in the Smallville, where they're the same age.
I think the bald head makes it seem like he's older.
Yeah. None of this weird wig.
Yeah, I mean, I got that maybe he hadn't transformed into that version of Lex Luthor yet, but still, the way he portrayed it, the way he was a little too wacky, especially that scene when Jesse Eisenberg was, Lex Luthor was talking right before Superman and Batman meet, right? He's talking, he's giving a speech, and he starts like saying stuff that he can't process from his brain out of his mouth, right? And he starts stumbling on his words.
Yeah.
Lex Luthor would never do that. He'd be
confident.
Very confident.
He's like a senator type. He yeah. talks a lot.
I mean,
he owns the business.
He becomes the president in the comics at one point.
Oh, I was not aware of that.
Yeah, he becomes the president.
Yeah. He reminds me like a Norman Osborn type of.
Yeah.
Yeah. And one thing that bothers me is the formula. I don't think they're going about this the right way.
Oh, the way that they're doing, you know, the team movie and then the solo movies?
Yes. Like, because Marvel has it down. They know what they're doing.
Marvel did it right. They did this, the solo movies.
They started this gangster shit.
Yeah.
You mean to tell me that's the thanks they get? Come on now.
And what was cool about the Marvel movies is at the end of each solo movie, they would show, like, Nick Fury coming in.
Yeah, that was big. After Iron Man, you knew game was on.
Yeah.
Doing this. This one, they didn't really... For Superman, they didn't really do that because this is the Iron Man of the DC.
Yeah, that was the first
movies.
One. Yeah,
and I didn't get that vibe.
No, not at all.
It's like they didn't know that it was gonna happen. Probably.
I honestly believe when they made this movie, they weren't thinking Batman vs Superman, Ben Affleck.
They're like, hey, let's just get a movie out.
Yeah, they got a movie out, and now they Zack Snyder was like, oh, let's just try building off this. Yeah. Which
it didn't even get a sequel. It went straight to Batman Superman, which is technically. I heard a Superman sequel, technically.
Yeah, I mean, Doomsday is a Superman villain.
Doomsday sucked too.
And he sucked in that movie.
Oh my gosh. The Doomsday I know from the comics is an unstoppable force. You know what I mean? He kills him.
Yeah.
He kills Superman.
Which he does in Batman and Superman, but it felt like it was like a very like, end of the movie, let's have some more fighting, let's try to squish it in. Now it's a 3-hour movie and Superman's dead.
Yes.
It felt just rushed and...
And we kind of know he's not going to be dead in this one because some of the pictures they show, Superman's in them.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you've seen any, but they...
I don't think I saw him in the pictures, but...
I've seen a few of him.
I just hope that they bring him back not at the end of the Justice League movie.
I'm calling it right now. Third act of that movie, we're not going to see him till the end.
That sucks.
Yeah. They're like, hey, we suck. Let's go get this guy.
I mean... Ben Affleck's gonna have to leave the
and
Justice
League. He's gonna need a shovel. Because he's in the ground.
Oh, well, seeing the trailer, it looks like.
I think that's illegal. I think you can just go up and unbury somebody.
Seeing the Justice League trailer, I think Aquaman's gonna steal that movie.
Yeah, he's like the Hulk and Thor.
Khal Drogo?
Movie. Oh,
Khal Drogo?
No, I haven't seen Game of Thrones, so I can't. I know what you mean, though. I mean,
he's the last one to bump Khaleesi.
Oh, yeah. But that's another thing. We're talking about the DC.
Yeah.
So, formula sucks. I don't like it.
Yeah, the way they've set up their movies is.
And don't get us wrong. I want these movies to succeed.
I want these movies to succeed more so than Marvel.
Yeah.
I'm more of a fan of DC and their comics and their stories than Marvel. I mean, I love Marvel. It's awesome. But I've wanted DC to really go more. We got a knock at the door, sorry. Come in, Spencer.
No, don't do that at all. Anyway, so yeah, I want the movies to succeed, and I think with the future of it, we have a Batman movie that Ben Affleck seems like he's not happy. He's, like he wants to do it, but he looks angry about it, because I think Live by Night people ask more about Batman than Live by Night.
Yeah, but fuck by Live by Night. I haven't seen that movie, and I probably won't ever see that movie.
No. If it's not the town, I don't want to
see it. He's doing, He's doing Batman right now. He's doing them good. And
like, get used to it, bro.
Him and Geoff Johns writing a solo Batman movie, that's great. I heard though that it got
he's not directing it. No
it more. Got edited by another writer before they turned it in, and then they had some other dude make some corrections, but do some stuff in the script.
Yeah.
But if it sticks to like a Geoff Johns and Ben Affleck script of a solo Batman movie, that movie's gonna be sick.
Yeah, everything about it is gonna be good. Because Geoff Johns, let's be honest, the guy's a magician when it comes to...
You know, he hasn't... The only thing, he's been doing the animated movies, huh, for DC. He hasn't done like an actual...
Well, he's the head honcho over there now.
Yeah.
He's in charge of everything.
You know, he actually used to write for Marvel for the Avengers. Like, late 90s.
Yeah.
And then he came over to DC and just turned it on its head. He literally came over to DC and restarted the universe in the comics, right? And then he did it again by doing Flashpoint.
Well, let's hope he does it with the Batman.
Yeah, I think,
and I don't know if it's the trailers. Like I said, the trailers, they're tricky. Wonder Woman looks good.
It looks great.
But that's what I thought about Suicide Squad too.
Yeah, so exactly.
Like, do I go in with high hopes? I think I'm over it. I think I'm just gonna go.
I remember coming up
and not have any anticipation.
Suicide Squad coming out, and it was like, okay, this is gonna be the DC movie that does it, right? This is gonna be fucking sick. And then it flops. And I have this same thing, like, I feel like I'm feeling the same thing with Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
Like, oh, this is gonna be our movie. This is gonna be the one that hits. Like,
should I just wait till it gets on video? I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna go to the movie theater. I'm gonna throw the $12 or whatever it costs, only because I like watching movies and it's fun. That Thursday night release, I ain't waiting till Friday. F that.
Yeah.
But I think as right now, it looks good, but the Justice League trailer, I didn't really vibe.
You know, I liked the Justice League trailer.
I think, yeah, you liked it. I did it.
I liked it for Aquaman, and I liked it for Batman.
They highlighted a lot of Aquaman in there.
Yeah, I think it's going to be kind of a Batman-Aquaman movie until Superman shows up. And it's going to be all about the return of Superman.
Yeah.
So,
It's close to 3 hours, so they're going to show a lot. I think they're probably going to throw every origin story from Cyborg to Flash.
How long were the Avengers movies? Were they were pushing 3 hours.
Close.
Really?
Yeah. There was like a Transformers movie that was like 3 hours.
That was just too long.
Yeah. It's a lot of robots.
Too many.
Yeah.
Okay, so now, yeah, future movies of Wonder Woman I don't want to have high hopes for it because I don't want to get let down again.
Yeah. I don't want to go into any more of these movies being positive. These Marvel movies, heck yeah. And I'm sorry, I'm more Marvel than... You're DC, I would say that.
For sure.
And he doesn't own a DC shirt, but I do, so I don't know if we need to fix that or what.
I own a couple DC shirts.
I don't think... He has like a Batman
shirt. They come out on special occasions.
I guess this isn't special enough. Anyway. So, Justice League, you think the trailer for Justice League is better than Wonder Woman? I think the opposite.
No, I wouldn't say it's better than Wonder Woman, but I like the Justice League trailer. Yeah.
Okay. And then we got The Flash coming up, but not for a while. We're not going to see these movies for a minute. This year only consists of Wonder Woman. This is 2017 if you're watching this thing in like 2020. I don't know why we would still be somewhere. I don't know.
Maybe we're big hits by then.
Hopefully. The guy can dream. I'll cheers to that.
Cheers.
Running out. Anyway, all we have this year is Wonder Woman and Justice League.
For the DC, yeah.
Yeah. So... I'm saying they're both gonna be successful, obviously. People are gonna go watch them.
Yeah, that's the thing, is all those movies still make money.
Yeah.
Batman made $900 million.
Yeah, they sucked.
Yeah.
But they still make money. But there's people who like these movies.
I like Batman vs Superman, but there were just parts of it that I didn't like I think were too big to...
I think I just fanboyed too much and I had high hopes and it just didn't go the way I wanted it.
Yeah.
And that's what is why I'm so negative about these movies.
Well, we were talking about it before we started the show that, you know, they should have DC, if they want to do the team movie first, I'm okay with that, but you can't try to squeeze all these origins in for Batman and Wonder Woman and Flash and Cyborg. It's just going to be too much.
That's what kills the movies, is they put too much at once.
You know, some people might not like it, but you throw a movie in with these characters in their prime and they're just going ham on a villain. They decide to come together. This is the first time they're deciding to come together.
Yeah.
And they go ham on a villain, a good villain like Darkseid. Cool. And then after that team movie, you start making solo movies that show their origin, show backstories, maybe leading up, maybe even going past, you know, like that.
That's why I think Marvel did it right, is that we got it's like the boss battle. We had a bunch of bosses before we got to that final boss.
You get solo movies with smaller bosses, showing origin stories, yeah. And then leading up to the Avengers,
yeah.
And then you see
think that was perfect.
Yeah, that was
awesome. And there might be some good or bad movies in that thing. I'm not saying they're all great in the Marvel Universe, but the formula they used to make that universe was great. Mm-hmm. And I just don't think DC has it.
And the other thing with Marvel too is they're not trying to get so grounded that they become too dark, they become too dramatic. Whereas I feel like DC is starting to literally put too much of a dark shade on the movie screen. And on top of it, they have this dark, grungy type of storyline. Yeah.
And I just think that they don't want to be like Marvel. That's why they're doing it.
Yeah, I think so too.
It's not working for them.
They don't even do the post-credit scenes like Marvel does.
Because I think the Marvel characters are more darker than these guys. If it's not Batman, everybody else is lighthearted and, you know,
yeah,
bright. Batman's the only one dark.
Should be.
Yeah, he's the only grumpy one.
Yeah, but it seems like Superman throws temper tantrums. Yeah. Like, oh, I killed General Zod.
Yeah, so for some reason, some DC executives that watch this video, which would be kind of cool. We don't hate your movies. We just want you to be better. You're like, we have two children in our household. One's Marvel, one's DC. We just like Marvel a little better, but we're down to kick it with the other child.
We still love the other kid.
Yeah, we just think.
But we're not going to get a good price on the black market for that
kid. Yeah, and the other one's very successful, like football player, and he's going to be an unstoppable athlete.
So we're going to try to make you like Marvel a little bit, but also different.
Yeah, but that's it. I think we've hit on every note how we feel.
Yeah, I feel, actually, that was cathartic for me. I got a lot of stuff off my chest.
I felt like we're in therapy. Yeah.
I'm better.
You're good?
I think I'm good.
I feel like I should be laying down and then, I feel like that's what I did do, is lay down and just give you all how I felt.
I thought I was laying down this whole time.
Oh, shit.
That was,
fucking far out, dude. Well, that's a wrap, ladies and gentlemen.
That's a wrap.
Episode 3. Maybe 4 is coming soon. We don't know. We don't know if we have time. But check out Babylon Creations for more. And hit us up on the comments if you want to hear us talk about something.
Throw us your feedback.
See if you agree with us.
Give us some topics.
Y'all definitely feel. We're out.